This is Mission Control Houston. The hatch is now open to the Pirs docking compartment. The official start time for today's spacewalk, 9:35 a.m. Central Time, 10:35 a.m. Eastern Time, right on the dot, beginning the 207th spacewalk in support of space station assembly, maintenance, and upgrades.
We're going out of eclipse.
Sunrise. The International Space Station moving into an orbital sunrise just north of New Zealand, soon to cross the South Pacific.
Sunglass situation going with your visor. You bet.
Working in tandem, cosmonauts Alexander Misurkin and Anton Shkaplerov making their way down the length of the Zvezda Service Module to the work site at the very aft end of the module to begin to set up all of their tools and other equipment for the disconnection of a high-gain antenna electronics box, the original box launched with the Zvezda Service Module back in July of 2000 that will be replaced with an upgraded model, the older box to be jettisoned retrograde from the station later in today's spacewalk, which is now 45 minutes in duration. Be 52 minutes into today's spacewalk, equipped with all of their tools, tethers and other equipment for their work today at the aft end of the service module. Alexander Misurkin and Anton Shkaplerov slowly but surely making their way back to their work site at the very end of the Russian segment of the International Space Station. Prominent in the field of view is the Pirs docking compartment, the airlock from which they emerged, opening the hatch at 9:34 a.m. Central Time to begin this spacewalk, the second of the year, the 207th spacewalk in support of space station assembly, maintenance, and upgrades. At the lower right-hand corner of your screen, you see solar arrays that are folded accordion-like style. Those solar arrays belong to the first element of the International Space Station, the Zarya module, that was launched on November 20th, 1998, from the Baikonur Cosmodrome atop a proton rocket to begin the era of the International Space Station. Those arrays no longer needed, with the power supply shared between the U.S. and Russian segments of the International Space Station and augmented through the solar panels on the Zvezda service module. At the two-hour mark into today's spacewalk, Alexander Misurkin and Anton Shkaplerov are working at the aft end of the Zvezda service module, well into the work to loosen up frames, electrical connectors and cables holding an electronics box associated with the Lyra high-gain antenna. This box to be removed and replaced with a high-frequency wideband receiver antenna for the high-gain antenna that was launched with Zvezda back in July of 2000. This will upgrade the performance of the telemetry and high data rate capability on the Russian segment of the International Space Station and make it similar to the data rate seen in the U.S. Ku-band communication system on the U.S. segment of the station. Crew is in the process of using their tools to loosen up this electronics box from the frame that it is housed in at the aft end of the service module as part of the assembly of the Lyra high-gain antenna. This then will enable them to gain access to all of the cables and connectors that they have to demate over the course of the next couple of hours of this portion of today's spacewalk.
Here, is that correct?
Next up for the two spacewalkers will be the process of demating a series of electrical connectors and cables and removing this electronics box altogether
in place. And
temporarily parking it at the back end of the service module while they install the replacement box, an upgraded electronics box that will provide even better telemetry capability for the Russian segment. This unit, the electronics box, if you will, is a wideband communications unit comprised of a frame with several electronics and transmission boxes installed inside the frame. The new unit that is being installed will provide a wideband communications capability. It weighs about 60 pounds, measuring about 2 feet by 1.5 feet by a half a foot.
You said that your cameras are not recording, but in
like this. One more time, let's check the position. Let's check the position of the jettison.
This is Mission Control Houston. 4 hours, 6 minutes into the spacewalk. Again, you're looking at the helmet camera view from Alexander Misurkin. He's holding the removed electronics box, and there it goes. They have accelerated the time frame for the jettisoning. The jettisoning occurring at 1:40 p.m. Central Time, 2:40 p.m. Eastern Time, with the crew running slightly behind schedule on its timeline. The decision was made by the Russian flight controllers to jettison the old electronics box for the Lyra high-gain antenna. You just saw Misurkin cast it away retrograde from the aft end of the Zvezda service module, and there it goes. The International Space Station currently flying over the North Atlantic, just off the east coast of the United States.
Let's continue discussion. Our task is to remove the transportation frame first attached to ourselves.
Sir,